Welcome back to my channel. So, today I am refilming a video that got deleted 2 weeks ago. In the past 2 weeks, a few things have been going crazy. I had to go to Arizona, and then we got back from Arizona. There was just so many different things. I also had my birthday, so I took 2 weeks off, and it is back to the grind again. So today I wanted to talk about beginner believer tips. I know that when I first started, and by the way, I am by no means an expert, I'm still kind of a beginner myself, I had a lot to learn. I did not know where to start. I felt overwhelmed. The Bible is a big book, you know, and I can only learn in certain ways, and I wanted to make sure I paid attention, and just so many different things, and I kept setting up barriers for myself to not further my faith. And so during this time of me being injured and all of this different crazy stuff happening in my life right now, God called me to Him, and I'm slowly working on my relationship with Him. So let's hop into some tips that should help you if you're a new believer. Tip number one is my tip that I use for everything in this whole entire world is baby steps. Start small. If you start out saying, I'm gonna read the whole Bible in 2 weeks and I'm gonna, you know, pray 24/7, girl, you're not probably gonna get that far. I mean, maybe you will. I don't know if that's God's will for your life, but honestly, what I found to be so helpful is just taking a little part of my day every day to spend some time with God it's like a therapy session for me, you know, talk about my problems, get some peace for that, start to trust God more and more and learn more about Him. And honestly, I think that's just the best way to do it, unless God calls you to jump right in which case, go for it. I cannot relate to that. My next tip would be to try a devotional. So I thought that I needed to do, you know, a whole Bible thing, you know, hop into, oh, let's read Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, and, you know, everything will make sense. And that's just not how life works. That's not how each believer's trail works, road works. I don't know what the correct terminology for that would be. Try a devotional, and honestly, I think that makes it a lot easier. Easing into the Bible in that kind of way is less intimidating. It's less stress. I don't know, I felt super duper stressed out. I felt like I had no idea what to do, where I was going, what I was thinking about. Just so many different things that I was trying to think about and figure out that I know God didn't want me to stress about, but when you're a new believer, you have so many different questions. And so honestly, trying a devotional is probably the best way to do it. They're typically really short little paragraphs paired with a verse, or the verse, you know, ties into the paragraph, whatever it is. And you can find them in bookstores. You can find them on the Bible app, which I'll talk about a little bit later. And honestly, I think that everybody should be doing a devotional. The thing that honestly saved my life was YouTube videos, YouTube video devotionals. And the amazing thing about that is there's so many great channels. I will tag in my description the two people that I would watch all the time, and they truly saved my life. They were the highlight of my day and the only thing I looked forward to. It would be like 3 to 4 hours after I did my devotional, and I just couldn't wait to wake up the next morning and do another one, because that's when I felt God's presence, God's peace that whole entire time. And it was honestly such a blessing to be able to watch that YouTube channel. I cannot remember her name, but she is incredible. So highly recommend watching those. Something that I highly, highly, highly recommend is getting a Bible that you can actually understand. So what I mean by that is there's like New King James, there's King James, I can't remember all of them, but Lord knows I can't understand a single one of them. And that was always the thing that deterred me from reading the Bible, was not being able to understand it. It felt like I was reading Shakespeare. It seemed like boring to me. You know, that sounds bad, but like, when you can't understand something and like what they're all trying to say, you just don't want to read it, because what's the point if you're not going to be able to get anything from it? So the book that I recommend is called The Book. So The Book is so incredible. Oh my gosh. It is the simplest, and I mean the simplest way to read the Bible. It is broken down to the easiest words you could think of. I don't have to look up words or meanings when I read this book. It even gives you a Bible reading plan. It tells you the books of the Bible chronologically. That's how you say it, I think. And New Testament, Old Testament. It just gives you so many different options, so many different ways to find the books in the Bible. It makes it so incredibly easy. So I highly recommend getting the book. I think it was not even $20 too on Amazon. And this queen is what saved my life as well. My next piece of advice, and my sound's going to sound a little weird here because I need two hands, is to start a Bible study journal or a war journal or a prayer journal, some sort of journal to put all of your thoughts, feelings, prayers, anything like that into one place. I started using this as my devotional journal. I'm hoping to get another journal to do a prayer journal or a war journal or even a war binder, because I feel like that's a really great way to dive in even more. And it's like your own little war room. It's a perfect place to meet with God and to battle against daily life stresses and anxieties and all of that. So with the journal that I have, I am actually almost done with filling it up, but I just have each lesson. So I write, you know, this one was about prayer and why it's important. And so I'll write down the verses and then I'll give like a brief kind of explanation or paragraph about why I feel like it's important or something about that lesson that I found important. I write that here. I change it up a little bit throughout each kind of like bit in my life. So that was when I first started out, and now I do, this is when I was studying Psalms. And so I put my thoughts, and then I put the little verse that was there. I put the little verse that came with it at the bottom, just, you know, switching it up. And I, like I said, I am almost filled this whole thing up. So I'm gonna need a new one soon, but this is like all I have left. Honestly, this is another thing that saved my life. Now, whenever I'm anxious and God has already given me that peace in the past, I can reflect on when I'm super anxious or super stressed out, I can look at the verses that I wrote down in that time of need, and I can remember that feeling, and I can feel God's presence once again to remind me that this life is going to be crazy, but God is always with you, and he can give you the peace that you need whatever time of day. And so this is just such a blessing when it comes to if you're feeling discouraged, if you're feeling anxious. I highly recommend kind of doing a little devotional or a little study on each kind of emotion that you struggle with, so that way you can always go back and reflect on it. Another amazing tool that I highly recommend is the Bible app. I actually just recently found it, I think, a month or two ago, and it is incredible. You can find devotionals or Bible studies or anything you really need for anything. I'm currently doing a love your boyfriend or love your significant other kind of devotional. So it really just sits you down and it shows you, if you're really upset with that person, how can you deal with it better? If you're feeling kind of low and lost, this is how you can make yourself feel better with the situation, how, when to look to God, when to, just so many different things. And that's how I studied Psalms. That's how I studied anxiety. There's just so many different things that you can look up, and they have a devotional or a Bible study for it. Literally everything. If you want to read the whole Bible, they have a whole thing on that too. So highly recommend you getting it. It is free. That is the best part about it, is it is completely free with so many different things on there. By the way, this is not sponsored. It's just such an amazing app. My last and most important piece of advice is to pray. So little backstory, when I was younger, I grew up in a Christian household. We went to church, and my father wasn't necessarily religious, but my mother was. And so we would go to church and all of that fun stuff, and it kind of, we stopped going for a lot of different reasons. But something that I always kept up until I went to high school was I prayed every single night before bed. And I noticed that my sleep would be bad if I forgot to pray. Throughout high school, I stopped praying as much. I only prayed when I was anxious, and that wasn't good. That wasn't the best thing in the world to do. So now that I'm a new believer, I'm born again, I try to pray at least 3 to 4 times a day. And if that sounds like a crazy goal to you, then girl, just do one. Just try to pray at least once a day. You know, ask for God's guidance through your day, through your life in the morning. I feel like that's the best way to do it. Thank God for waking you up. Thank God for everything that you have. If you have a house, whether it's good or bad, or if you have an animal or, you know, a car, something like that, I always just try to thank him for all of these blessings that I have, because I could be living in a tent. So I'm gonna say thank you for that. But anyway, there is no right or wrong way to pray. I don't suggest like cursing, but you know, it's your own personal conviction. It's your own life. It's whatever you want to do with it. So pray however you want. Just pray to feel God's presence, and I promise you your life will change. So I hope that helped at least one or two new believers. I know that I needed something like this when I first started out and I just couldn't find it. I hope that God blesses you today. I hope that you're doing okay in this crazy time. We are living in such a crazy time, but what a blessing it is that we have an amazing and almighty God. So I just want to say, have an amazing day. Please wear your face mask, please. I don't know, I just feel like we could save so many more lives if we wear a face mask. I do believe that Black Lives Matter. Their people and their lives do matter. I hope you wash your hands. I hope you have an amazing, blessed day. Jesus loves you. Goodbye.